Good morning, children. Welcome to another session of our e-learning program. I hope you enjoyed our previous class. That is three laws of motion. Now observe your surroundings and think that which law is acting on the action which is happening around you. About three laws of motion. Okay, today's session we are going to learn about what is impulse, and before that we learn about the experiment which is done by the great scientist Galileo Galilei. So Galileo Galilei stated that an object in motion will remain in same motion as long as no external force is applied on it. Already we learned that is first law. Also, if the object is moving, if there is no obstructing force, the object will go on continue further to the infinite. But it is not possible. We are having frictional force, we are having gravitational force, and we are having so many resisting forces. Okay. In absence of external forces, what Galileo came up with the two ingenious thoughts experiments. He did this experiment on inclined planes with smooth surfaces, and observed that the smoother the surface, the further the ball traveled. Here the surface, if you observe, the surface is very smooth. Whenever the surface is very smooth, the ball is traveling. The ball is covering more distance. This we know. But what he added that if the surface is smooth, the ball covers more distance. And he added one more point to that. So when the ball is coming from the lower slope or higher altitude to low ground level, the velocity is increasing. And when it is going up, the velocity is decreasing. Why it is velocity is increasing here, and why velocity is decreasing here? When it is coming, velocity is increasing. Why it is going in this direction, the velocity is decreasing. Why? What is the reason behind this? Yes, why? Because when it is coming down, the gravitational force is acting. So the net force is increasing. That's why the velocity is increasing. When it is going upward direction, and the gravity is acting downward direction and normal force, that's why the velocity is decreasing when it is moving up. This is the experiment done by the great scientist Galileo and Galilei, and he observed. He observed that it depends on the angle also. So if angle of inclination, this angle is called angle of inclination. If angle of inclination is decreased, then he observed that the ball is going and it is reaching exact the same height. And here we leave the ball from this height and the ball is going to the exact same height when the surfaces are smooth and there is no very very minimal friction is offered by this surface. Chala simple ma. Surface friction lekapothe, so ekkadaithe leave chesamo, if the both angles are equal, here the point condition number 2 is both the angle of inclinations are same, then the ball reaches same height on the other side. This is the second observation he did. And the marble rolled up the same height. Here the marble rolled up the same height, but it had to go further in this instance. See here, the distance is, so here when here both are same, here it covered d equal to d, it covered same distance. And when the angle of inclination is here, this angle of inclination is more and the angle of inclination is less, then it covered more distance. If you observe by seeing, you can say this, it covered more distance. That means the distance covered by object depend on the angle of inclination. If this angle is more, suppose this is x and this is y, if x is more, here it covers in the surface B, the object has to cover more distance. So mana roller coasters kani, slides in water worlds. If e application e laws ni use cheskoni ee formulas use cheskoni they will design. Meer observe chesi untaru mana water la wonderla or else alan chotkelte here we will slide. Manam ila slide chestam, just imagine, observe cheyandi, we will slide over here, ikkada water untundi, again we will go up and we will come back. Eppudaina have you experienced that game? Yes, ilanti even roller coaster shapes kuda ilane untai. So how they will design? By using these laws. If it is too small, here the angle of inclination, this is path, second angle of inclination is too small, here first one is large, then it covers more distance here. But the common condition is, in this condition, In this is third condition. In third condition also ball covers the same height. The second condition, in second condition also ball covers same height. This is the first condition. Even in the first condition also balls cover same height. Ball same height cover chestundi. If angles are equal, it covers same distance. If angle is more, it covers more distance in the second part. Here in the third also, if angle of inclination second part is very less, at the second part it travels more distance. So eppudaina second part lo travel cheyali ante angle of inclination difference undali, then only it can travel, it covers more distance. These are the Galileo's experiment. He experimentally proved, so the barbel released at its initial height rolled down due to the force of gravity and then moves up the slope until it reaches the initial height, then the reduce of angle of upward slope, and did the same experiment. So when he did the angle of slope, then the marble rolled up with the same height, but it had to go further in the instance. That means the distance traveled by it is greater. He made this observation by further reducing the angle. So here further reducing the angle, he made this observation by further reducing angle of upward slope. This angle of upward slope, he got that the same result. So in the three experiments, he got the same result. If you see what it is changing, so angle of slope he is changing. So when he is changing angle of slope, it is traveling more distance, but it is covering same height. It's traveling up to the same height. So this reaches the same height, the ball had to go further each time. So then a question arises in his mind, how far most it has to move to reach the same height? If it has no slope to go up, if there is no slope, what it will do? It will go further. Practically it will go in the same direction. After the slope, the ball will continue in the direction. Suppose if the surface is frictionless, if there is no friction, ball continues gala infinite varaku velthundi. Kani it's very difficult, as we can't repair the surface without friction. Friction lekunda surface tayar cheyalem kabatti, because of resistance, ball some kontha dooram velli, it will travel some distance and stops. So how can we reduce? Already we learned in previous class, by applying oil on the surface or by smoothing the surface. So he did this experiment. He concluded that the natural state of a moving object, if it is free of external influences, that means if there is no frictional force, in uniform motion, it will go in the same direction. So there is it will go continuously up to a long, long, long distance. So by taking this idea, Isaac Newton prepared his three laws of motion. Okay children, this is about, so it depends, the object when it is traveling in inclined plane, it depends on how much distance it travels, depends on the angle of inclination and angle of slope. This is called angle of inclination and this is called angle of slope. It depends on this, children. This is the topic, and the next one is that some lab activity we are having in this lesson is action reaction experiment. For this, it's very simple experiment. Take a test tube, this is retard stand, take a test tube and this is Bunsen burner, retard stand. Hang the test tube like this. Just hang the test tube like this. This is detach stand and Bunsen burner. If we hang this and take water into the test tube, what are the materials required to this experiment? A test tube, threads to hang, and Bunsen burner, a retard stand, and a rubber cork. Just take water into the test tube. And what test tube lo ki water teeskoni, just ila incline ga cheyali. It should not be straight. Generally, we'll take our test tubes like this. ఇలా టెస్ట్ ట్యూబ్స్ తీసుకుంటాం బట్ ఇన్స్టెడ్ ఆఫ్ దట్ టు దిస్ ఎక్స్పెరిమెంట్ వీ హ్యావ్ టు కీప్ అవర్ వాట్ వీ కెన్ సే టెస్ట్ ట్యూబ్ ఇన్ ఇన్క్లైన్ పొజిషన్ అండ్ వీ హ్యావ్ టు కవర్ ద టెస్ట్ ట్యూబ్ విత్ రబ్బర్ కార్క్ వెన్ వీ హీట్ దిస్ టెస్ట్ ట్యూబ్ ద వాటర్ విచ్ ఈస్ ఇన్సైడ్ ద టెస్ట్ ట్యూబ్ విల్ గెట్ హీటెడ్ అప్ అండ్ వాటర్ టర్న్స్ టు వాటర్ వేపర్ అండ్ లోపల ఉన్న వాటర్ వేపర్గా కన్వర్ట్ అవుతుంది అండ్ దెర్ ఈస్ నో స్పేస్ ఫర్ ద వాటర్ వేపర్ టు ఎస్కేప్ దాని నుంచి పార్ వాటర్ వేపర్ ఎస్కేప్ అవడానికి ప్లేస్ లేదు దెన్ వాట్ హ్యాపెన్స్ అప్పుడు ఏం జరుగుతుందంటే ఇట్ కమ్స్ అవుట్ ఇట్ బ్లోస్ అవుట్ దీనిలో ఉన్న రబ్బర్ కార్క్ని గట్టిగా తోసేస్తుంది వెన్ రబ్బర్ కార్క్ మూవ్స్ ఇన్ దిస్ డైరెక్షన్ వెన్ ద రబ్బర్ కార్క్ మూవ్స్ ఇన్ ద సి హియర్ రబ్బర్ కార్క్ ఈస్ ఫాలోయింగ్ డౌన్ వెన్ ద రబ్బర్ కార్క్ ఈస్ మూవింగ్ ఇన్ ద ఫార్వర్డ్ డైరెక్షన్ ద టెస్ట్ ట్యూబ్ మూవ్స్ ఇన్ ద బ్యాక్వర్డ్ డైరెక్షన్ వీ కెన్ అబ్జర్వ్ దిస్ వెన్ వీ డూ ద ఎక్స్పెరిమెంట్ వీ కెన్ అబ్జర్వ్ దిస్ రబ్బర్ కార్క్ ఈస్ మూవింగ్ ఫార్వర్డ్ డైరెక్షన్ అండ్ టెస్ట్ ట్యూబ్ ఈస్ మూవింగ్ బ్యాక్వర్డ్ డైరెక్షన్ సో దట్ ఈస్ వెన్ రబ్బర్ కార్క్ ఈస్ మూవింగ్ ఫార్వర్డ్ డైరెక్షన్ దట్ ఈస్ యాక్షన్ అండ్ ద టెస్ట్ ట్యూబ్ ఈస్ గోయింగ్ బ్యాక్వర్డ్ డైరెక్షన్ దట్ ఈస్ రియాక్షన్ దిస్ ఈస్ యాక్షన్ రియాక్షన్ ఎక్స్పెరిమెంట్ దిస్ ఈస్ అబౌట్ activity we are having for Newton's third law. This is the activity. After that, this is we having a some other another topic in our textbook, that is how to know pulling two springs, third law of motion. This is also example. These are the activities we are having, third law of motion. So take two spring balances and with the help of hook fix one spring balance at one end of the table and now simply try to pull the second spring balance which is in your hand. If you observe the readings, so how much reading it is showing, the same reading we can able to see here on the second spring balance. So see, initially the value is zero. If you apply some force, it is showing 1.5 here, and the same value it is showing here. And if you move further, so it is showing 200 and the both spring balances. So here initially zero, it's moving equally in the both spring balance. That means for every action there is opposite and equal reaction. How much force we are applying, the same force is acting on the two spring balances. This is another experiment we are having for action reaction experiment. The last topic we are having is impulse. What is impulsive force? The last topic for this lesson. So large force, so it's simple, but so many application questions we will get for the exams. Large force that acts over a short period of time during collision or explosion is called impulsive force. Again, I'm repeating, large force that acts on a short period of time. If large amount of force is acting on a short period of time, that is called impulsive force. The rate of change of momentum is example for impulsive force. So what is the example and we are having impulsive force are if you drop a egg on a pillow, so an impulsive force is denoted with the letter P. So we'll go to the next slide. Say, so tennis ball. So if large force is acting on the ball for short period of time, it covers more distance. Okay, children, if large force is acting, so here this is also example for impulsive force. If just you having two eggs in your hand, just drop the two eggs from the same height. Here what is happening, here the first egg is you are dropping on a cushion or a pillow and second egg is on a concrete strong floor. So what will happen? Yes, the egg which is fallen on the cushion or pillow, there is no change, it won't break. But the egg which falls on the concrete floor or strong surface, it will break why, what is the reason behind it. So many times they ask the same question. So why, what is the reason behind this? If law, because, so cushion means, see here, the cushion surface will be like this initially. When the egg falls on the surface, it bends. It bends. So that's why, what is happening here? Here, large, small force is acting on the earth for a long time. So it cushion comes and it comes back to its original position. For this, a large force, small force is acting for long time. But here, there is no cushion-like feature for the concrete floor. There is no change in the surface of the concrete. When X falls on it, a large amount of force acts on the egg for short time. Here, these two sentences are very important. Here, short force is small amount of force is acting on the cushion for long time, but here large amount of force is acting on the egg for short time. So short time lo ekko force act aithe, so the effect will be more, effect ekko ga untundi. So that's why the egg will break. So same impulse. So whatever the drop an egg, whether you drop an egg on the floor or on a pillow, it loses all its momentum. The same impulse is applied in either cases, but stopping time is so much less for the floor. The force is proportionally great. So impulse, what is impulse? Force acts, force into time. Here in this condition, the time is more. The time is more, the time of impact is more. That's why that nothing happens to the egg which falls on the cushion. Same example, any brittle substance, man chetlonchi emna jarigi kinda padi pagilipoyina sare, reason ide. What we can say, that is impulsive force. If water bottle water full ga undu ankonni, adi tondaraga pagilipothundi if it drop, because more force is acting on the object for long time. That is impulsive force. Here also, even for rocket, when we tennis ball, when we strike the ball with the rocket, if we hit it with a great force with a short time, it covers a more distance. You may take so many examples we can do in our daily life. So this is the guys, this is about today's lesson. Today we learn experiment, Galileo's experiment and three laws of motion experiment. These are the topics we covered today. See here how it changes. When see the reading, observe the reading here. So initial zero, the both readings are equally changing. When we are pulling, the readings are changing. This is about our today's experiment. This is also experiment which is action reaction. If you do this experiment, if you come back, we will do the experiment. We can do this experiment in your lab. This is about Galileo's experiment. I want to conclude the lesson. We have to thankful to the great scientists who changed the approach of the topics science. Okay, children, we'll meet in another session. I hope we completed. We have one more topic left over here. That is law of conservation of momentum. That may be little tricky for you. It may be little difficult for us to do this in this session. But sure, one day we will sort it out. Before that, I want to give some tips for you. How to do the experiments and how to solve the problems. Hopefully, in our next session, we'll come with another lesson. That is our fourth lesson, reflection of light at plane surfaces. I hope you are doing great. Stay home, stay safe, happy learning, children. I hope you are watching the videos completely and carefully. Watch the video and do the given homework. Complete the notes. Writing and reading both are important, and you are writing test also. The team of teachers are very happy for their children. See you next time.